Okay. All right. Yeah, he called me, and I told him Sister Morgan had already asked me what I played. So. And then did he tell you what I said? I said,
"Are you doing what your wife asked you to do?"
Yeah. And I said, "Oh, yeah, right." Oh, wow. You know this stuff like Sunday. Last week I was sneezing and nose running, and it started draining some money. I didn't even make it to Sunday school because it just made me sick to my stomach. That's. Did that help? Okay. Well, like I said, that with the drink, girl, it made me sick to my stomach. And it's going around. It's because I called Mother Trice, and she said she got some kind of cold or something too. So I just said it you know, just going around. But anyway, thank you. I appreciate this one. Okay. Warren. Oh, I don't know. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, give the Lord a hand. We're here at the Homegoing celebration of our brother and friend and member, Brother Willie Morgan. Now, let me tell you something about Brother Willie Morgan. He would come in, he would sit by Brother Davis. Davis, wave your hand back there. He would sit by right there. And Brother Davis, sit straight up for a minute. Sit straight up, lock your shoulders, and let your head go down. And Brother Davis, when I get about right here in the sermon, and say, share something, Reverend. That was Brother Morgan. That was, amen, Brother Morgan. He was waiting on the hoop.
Praise God.
He missed everything else, but he caught the end of it. Oh, yeah, that must be. And then walk up and had the nerve to tell me, mighty word, Reverend, mighty word. That was my friend.
Yes.
I thank God for all of you today. Yes. We're going to turn you in the hands. From this day forward, Brother Morgan is setting a precedent for us. We will now always close the coffin right before we started the service or at the end. Never right before the preacher.
All right.
How traumatic is that for a family?
Amen. Uh-huh.
Yes.
And the most important thing in this service is the word of God.
Amen.
Come on, put your hand together, believer. So Brother Morgan is steady building and making stuff. He's helped. I'm battering Lily Missionary Baptist Church. I do want to recognize his uncle, Pastor Benny. Where's Pastor Benny at? There you go. Ray raised his hand. He pastored Brother Morg. Yeah, he's retired now. Yeah, he still got that preacher voice, don't he? Brother Morgan for years always trying to get us to fellowship, and he got us together. He got us together at his retirement, and he got us together at his celebration. And so want to thank God. Before we go any further, I want to say to the House of Johnson, they made Brother Morgan look alive.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let the owner come forward. Come, let the owner come forward. Come, come down, come down, come down. Stop right there, stop right there, stop right there. Now come a little bit further, come a little bit further. Stop, stop, stop. I just want to let him know. When I was over at the funeral home, he said, Pastor Hines, this is how the service gonna go. I said, yeah, go out there and read that sign on that. It's the House of Johnson, owner. I said, now when you over there, you in charge. When you get over to Lily Baptist, I'm gonna show you in charge. Come forward, stop, stop. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm gonna tell you, me and his father was good friends. His father helped me feed this community.
Yeah.
His father would come to my rescue and buy hams and turkeys to make the program go over. And I thought his father was the best mortician God put on earth. But I discovered through Brother Willie Morgan. Brother Morgan ain't never looked that good. Yeah, I walked by the coffin and I had to shake him and say, man, you playing, you sleep.
Amen.
Let's give them a hand. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. They're going to take over this part of the service and let the family have its part. Now, I need you all to be praying.
Yeah.
That's
right, Pastor.
Yes, Lord.
That's right.
What you experience in grieving is laughter and sadness.
Right.
And so as a man was baptizing a young man, he threw the boy in the water and the boy started to drown. And he said, Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. I just shook my head. So I said to you, Lord, have your way in this service today. We thank God just for a blessed day.
Yes.
We're going to honor our brother,
yes,
your husband, your father, your brother, your grandfather, your cousin, our friend.
Yes, God.
In Johnson's hand. And then the next voice you would hear would be Pastor Benny Gibson of Macedonia Baptist Church, who would narrate the rest of the service.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light. In the
God bless you to Pastor Hines and Lady Leck Hines and all the preachers. May the good Lord help all of us on today.
Yes, Lord.
we here to celebrate and to pray for the Morgan family.
Yeah.
Sister Morgan, we want you to know we're holding you up each and every day, as well as the rest of the family.
Yeah.
We gonna miss Mr. Morgan. I call him Mr. Morgan. And every time I would call him Mr. Morgan, he would say, "Yes, sir." We grateful for the time that God gave us.
Yeah.
And the time that we spent with Mr. Morgan. We grateful for that.
Yeah.
Grateful for the years that he blessed him and Sister Morgan all those years to be married.
Yeah.
So we grateful, saints. And we grateful that God blessed all of those that traveled over the highway. And brought you here safely.
Yeah.
I learned a lot from Mr. Morgan. If I would call him, he would be right over to help me, whatever I needed help with. And thank God we spent just the last week together. But one thing about Mr. Morgan, he'll work for you.
Yeah.
But he had to get paid. Yes, sir. It wasn't about no credit. He wanted to get paid. Yeah, no. Yeah. He said, "I do good work for you, but when I finish the job, you got to pay me." Amen. So we certainly thank God for Mr. Morgan and the years that we had him. But I also want to say this about Mr. Morgan. He lived two stages. Now, you look this up when you get home. That'll be your homework. There's life, which means there's breath in your body.
That's right.
That's life.
That's right.
But then there's living.
All right.
You can have life, but not be living.
Amen.
Now, if you look at them horses and carriages out there, you had to say he was living. If you look at his wife, you would have to say he was living. If you looked at the things that he built, you would have to say he was living. And so there's a difference between life and living. Living means that you have a purpose in life.
Yeah.
It means that you fulfill your purpose by getting up doing something every day.
Yeah.
It's about making progress. That's what living is. Living means that you earn wages in life and you can buy the things that you need in life. And you can enjoy the things in life that you really want to. That's living. That's living because when Adam got kicked out the garden, he was dead, but he was still living. He still had life, brother. And so I said that to say this, saints, if you have breath in your body, start living. Start to live. And I thank God for Pastor Hines and the family allowing me to do this. And here's the order of service. And we're going to respect the wish of Sister Morgan that we don't want to just wear people's out.
Amen.
But we do want to celebrate. And we want to respect the wish of Mr. Morgan, because if you know Mr. Morgan like I know him, he just don't lay around. Y'all will get that next week. So we thank God. We have prayer by Pastor Alexander, and then we have the scripture reading by Reverend Hicks and the Old Testament, New Testament. Then we have Reverend Davis to come, and then a solo behind that. May God bless you.
it is a, it's a good man who can pick at preachers and make them laugh. Brother Morgan could pick at you and make you laugh. Let us pray. Most holy and everlasting Father, Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Father of Brother Willie James Morgan, we're here today to celebrate his life. We're not here because he died, but we're here because he lived.
Yes, Lord.
And the way he lived, we appreciate. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for his marriage. Thank you for his children. Thank you for his relatives and so many friends. And Lord, we pray your strength and comfort in this time of bereavement. You promise never to leave us nor forsake us, to always be by our side. Brother Morgan will be missed. And we need you to give comfort. We need you to give strength. We need you to bless the memories and the example of Brother Morgan. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you would bless this celebration. You would bless the scriptures. You'd bless the song. You would bless the remarks. You would bless the eulogy. Bless your holy word that we would receive encouragement. Souls would be strengthened and some might be saved. Use Pastor Hines to your glory. We thank you that we have no doubt that Brother Morgan was a Christian. We thank you, we have no doubt that he belonged to you. And we're sure, absent from the body, he is present with you. Bless his memories. Keep us supportive of the family and the friends. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Praise God. We thank God for being here today, and we thank God for this opportunity to share with this fine family that I've been knowing for years. I'm kind of nervous, and I'll say I'm nervous because this is a fine family, and you want everything to go right. You know, you don't want nothing messed up. But giving out to God, Pastor Hines, and all of the preachers and all of God's family. And I've been knowing this family for years, and I'm here to read the Old Testament scripture, but I would just like to say this. Seeing Brother Morgan doing a job over by my home. So I would stop from time to time, and I asked him, why you do it like that? And he told me in three words, watch and learn. Watch.
All right.
And learn. I sealed my lips. Wasn't nothing left for me to say, because his word stood for him.
All right.
And I'm going to read the Old Testament scripture. It's coming from Job, the 14th chapter, and I'm going to read verses 1 through 14. And the scripture reads as follows. Man that is born of a woman is of few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not. And doest thou open thine eyes upon such as one and bringeth me into judgment with thee? Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one. Seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee. Thou hast appointed his bonds that he cannot pass. Turn from him that he may rest till he shall accomplish as an hireling his day. For there is hope of a tree if it is cut down, that it will sprout again, and that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stock thereof die in the ground, yet through the scent of water it will bud and bring forth sprouts like a plant. But man dieth and wasteth away. Yea, man giveth up the ghost, and where is he? As the waters fell from the sea, and the flood decayeth and drieth up, so man lieth down and resteth not, till the heavens be no more, that they shall not awake, nor be raised out of their sleep. Oh, that thou wouldest hide me in the grave, that thou wouldest keep me secret until thy wrath be past, that thou wouldest appoint me a set time and remember me. And the 14th verse reads as follows. If a man die, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time, I will wait till my change come. Yeah. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen.
Good morning. I've done a lot of things in my life, but this is probably the hardest. I buried my father Monday. 67 years with that man, and I do mean man. He worked and took us out of the state of Georgia so that we wouldn't have to live like he had to live.
All right.
He was a man. And I'm privileged and honored to stand for another man.
All right.
That worked on behalf of his family and his God. He served this church. Yeah. And this past.
Amen. Amen.
Absolutely. And I didn't think I was going to get through it. I didn't. Pastor said, you don't. But I thought about my father and that man who would have stood, who went to war twice. Mm. I'm sorry, my job is to. I want to tell you a quick story about Morgan, and I feel I can do this because I've had my feet under their kitchen table for many years, eating that barbecue and that fish.
Yeah. Amen.
Oh, he'd even put up a tent, wouldn't he? Yes, he would. But I lose my train of thought. What was I saying? Oh, no, you want me to go to work. Okay. Yes, thank you.
He's a mighty good teacher.
Some of y'all better think about letting your kids play football. I'm going to tell you that right now. Yeah. We were fishing up to St. John. I think Warren was with us, and I can't remember everybody was with us, but Morgan was there. And after we had fished the whole morning, we were hungry. And so we went into, I think, St. Joe or Benton Harbor, something. We went to get something to eat. And Morgan asked the man, said, do y'all have a senior menu? And I said, well, just show them your flip phone. They'll believe you. Y'all don't get that? Anyway, I'm reading from the text of John 11, 14 through 26. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. And I am glad for your sakes that I was not there, to intend ye may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. Then said Thomas, which is called Didymus, unto his fellow disciples, let us also go, that he may die with him. Then said Jesus, came he found that he had lain in the grave 4 days already. Now Bethany was nigh unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlongs off. And many of the Jews came unto Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brother. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still in the house. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou hast been here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to thee. Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Ain't that good news? Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. That great getting the morning is coming. On the 21st verse says, Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And the last verse, the 25th verse, which is good news. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? And the last thing I want to say, I used to say, call my friends and say, I lost my father. No, I didn't. There's a great getting up morning.
First, giving honor to God, who's the head of my life, Pastor Hines in the pulpit, Sister Hines, Sister Morgan, all of you. God knew the end at the beginning, but no man knows the day nor the hour. So I just say, if you don't have a personal relationship with the Lord, you should get one.
Amen.
My scripture reading is coming from Isaiah 43 and 1. But now, thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name. Thou art mine.
Thank you.
He knows my name. He knows my name. He knows my name. Oh, how he comforts me. Oh, how you counsel me. Hey, and it's give you my heart, Lord. Here in your presence, I am made new. You know my name. You victory, 'cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. No fire can burn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain, 'cause you hold my hand. I'm walking in your victory, 'cause your power lives within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. You hold my hand. You hold my hand. I don't have to be afraid, no. I don't have to be afraid. You hold my hand. You hold my hand. You know my name. You know my name. Oh, how you. Just to commune with you.
Oh, how you tell me
I belong to you.
Let me say something about that's the little baby that grew up. I'm going to do something in honor of Brother Morgan. He would say, that girl worked. And Brother Morgan, he would say, Reverend, pay the girl. I'm going to pay you in honor of my friend. Come on, let's give her a hand.
Praise God.
You can do what you want to do, but I'm going to be led of the Spirit.
All right.
Because if you don't believe me for the works.
Yeah.
I wish you understand what I'm trying to tell you. People will sit and critique anything and won't understand the move of God.
Yeah.
I woke up this morning and God said, write everybody a check you just come in contact with. Now, don't y'all be come greet me after church either. Come on, baby.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, we have got to do better than that. This is Mr. Willie James Moore. And if you knew him, he didn't have a shy bone in his body. He would meet you with the biggest hello, although today we're saying goodbye. But let's try it again. Let's tap into his spirit. Good morning.
Good morning.
That's it. That's it. Before I go any
yes, sir.
Further, any further, giving honor to God for allowing us to be here on today to celebrate his life. Honor to the shepherd of this house, Pastor James L. Hines, to First Lady-elect Sister Leontine Hines, to the clergy all over the building, and to this wonderful family. I am privileged to be here to read cards, condolences, the acknowledgments, and his journey. Mr. Morgan was so loved in this community. There are an abundance of cards, acknowledgments as well, but I will read just a few, and the family will acknowledge it at a later date. The acknowledgment. The family of the late Willie James Morgan is indeed grateful to each of you for your many acts of kindness, expressions of love, and thoughtfulness expressed during this time. We thank God for each of you and pray that he will continue to bless all of you. The mere words, thank you, cannot adequately express our gratitude. We, the family, will reach out to you at a later date, the Morgan family. And there are cards that we will acknowledge from Jimmy and Andrea Short, Mary Lucas, Sheila Dunklin, Mother Lacey's spiritual sons, Owen Brookings and Amos Kroom Jr., Albert and Minnie Peterson, Alonda Banks, Robbie Patterson, Paula Ware, Andre Langston, Mr. and Miss Will Sleepy Atkins, Mr. Freeman Martin, Robin Brimby, and family. There's a condolence from Second Missionary Baptist Church, 304 East Prospect, Jackson, Michigan, Reverend Darius L. Williams, Senior Pastor. Kingdom Life Ministries, where Reverend Pastor Fred Parker Jr. and First Lady Lauren Parker, Pastor and First Lady. New Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church, Pastor Benny J. Gibson, First Lady Brenda Gibson. St. Mark Missionary Baptist Church, 425 West Wardlow Street, Gates, Tennessee, 38037, Pastor Willie J. Campbell, Sr., a small church with a big heart. Resolution of respect for Mr. Willie James Morgan, a beloved member of our a former beloved member of our congregation. Today we are comforted by the words of our Lord in 2 Timothy 4, 7, and 8, which says, I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, and I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me that day. Whereas in the providence of all-knowing, all-powerful, divine heavenly Father have called home our beloved brother in Christ, Mr. Willie James Morgan, from our presence on Thursday, March 28, 2024, to dwell with him in the glories of paradise. Pastor Willie J. Campbell, Sr., and St. Mark Missionary Baptist Church family of Gates, Tennessee, feels that it is befitting to express our deepest sympathy and sincere prayers to the members of our church family, Sister Helen S. Nance and Brother Dean Strayhorn, during the passing of their nephew, Brother James Morgan. We know your loss is deep and your sorrow is great, but we want you to know we share in your sorrow. But more importantly, we recognize that this loss is heaven's gain. We also extend To Sister Laura Morgan and the entire Morgan family, our deep and sincere sympathy in your loss. And may you rely on God, who can and will heal all sorrow. Whereas we bow in acceptance of the perfection of God's plan to gather each of us into his merciful arms when we have fulfilled our purposes on this earth. Be it resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy kept in the church minutes. Prayerfully submitted on this 13th day of April, 2024, St. Mark Missionary Baptist Church family, Gates, Tennessee, Pastor Willie J. Campbell, Sr., Sister Hattie Lorraine Campbell, Church Secretary. Lily Missionary Baptist Church, to the family of Brother Willie James Morgan. Pastor James L. Hines and the Lily Missionary Baptist Church family wishes to extend our heartfelt sympathy in the passing of your loved one. Our prayers to the family are that the memories of him and the time he spent on this earth will console you at this time of bereavement. Life on earth is only a stopping place, a pause in what is to be, and a resting place along the road to sweet eternity. We all have different journeys that we take along the way. We were all meant to learn something, but we were never meant to stay. Our destination is a place far greater than we know. For some, the journey is quicker, and for some, the journey is slow. When the journey finally ends, we will all claim a great reward and find everlasting peace together with the Lord. May you cherish his memory and strive to meet him in the heavenly home that our Lord and Savior has prepared for his children. Let us accept God's will in calling his servant home to rest from his earthly labor. The family has our love, sympathy, and prayers. Humbly submitted, Lily Missionary Baptist Church, Jackson, Michigan, Reverend James L. Hines, Pastor, Elect Lady Leontine Hines. The obituary. His journey. On Thursday, March 28, 2024, Willie James Morgan was called from labor to reward. He was born in Gates, Tennessee on September 1, 1944, to the union of Linter T. and Lucy May Virginia Morgan. Willie was the oldest son of five children. He accepted Christ at an early age. Throughout grammar school and high school, Willie worked with his father and his grandfather picking cotton and learning hands-on how to build and renovate homes. When he did not have a hammer in his hand, he played baseball. He will always be known as the young man who hit the baseball over the high school to win the championship in 1962. That same year, Willie graduated from Halls Consolidated High School with a building trades certification. Willie grew up with and married the love of his life, Laura Lacey Morgan, on December 26, 1967. To this union, three children were born, and they loved being a blended family of seven, to include Willie's two older children. Seeking and wanting more for himself and his family, they migrated to Jackson, Michigan in 1966. His faith journey led him to unite with Lily Missionary Baptist Church, where he served faithfully until his death, under the leadership of Pastor James L. Hines. Over the years, Willie served in various ministries of the church. He was an usher, he worked as security in partnership with his wife, a trustee, and food preparation for various church and mission center functions. Shortly after arriving in Michigan, he began employment at the Malleable, aka Hayes Albion Corporation, aka Harvard Industries, in Albion, Michigan, as a general laborer while enhancing his skill set to become a heavy lift crane operator. Making utilization of his building trade certification while carrying on the family tradition, Willie maintained full-time employment in synchrony with his own business, Willie Morgan Remodeling. He was prominent for roofing, window and water heater installation, building decks, room additions, concreting driveways, etc. You name it, he could do it. If he couldn't, he would gracefully refer you to the most qualified candidate who could. Due to unforeseen circumstances related to his full-time position of 35 years, Willie was forced to make a career change and began working for the state of Michigan Department of Corrections as a contingent maintenance worker. With God's grace, along with enlightenment and career guidance from First Lady-elect Sister Leontine Hines, he received a permanent full-time position as a regional maintenance worker. Willie obtained a multitude of certifications that enabled him to raise his classification ranking. He retired from this role after 20 years of service. When Willie was not being a full-time employee or had a hammer in his hand, he enjoyed his two favorite hobbies, bowling and riding his motorcycles. In his bowling career, he participated in local leagues and in several out-of-state tournaments, resulting in one perfect 300 game. In Willie's younger motorcycle riding days, he was a member of the Flint Eagles Motorcycle Club, the Albion chapter. In his more seasoned riding days, he became a member of the Boogie Down Motorcycle Club, the Jackson chapter. He, along with his loving wife, Laura, and friends, have rode all over the continental United States. In his early 70s, he rode all the way to California and back. That's impressive. Amen. I get sleepy driving to Ann Arbor. That's impressive. Never one to sit still, Willie later took up four new hobbies: fishing, cooking fish, door dashing, and voting poll worker. He found so much joy, happiness, and serenity sailing on the Seven Chain Lakes in Jackson County that he never bowled or rode his motorcycle again. His favorite food was simply everything, with the exception of his mother's homemade tri-layer coconut cake that she would freeze and ship to him the next day. This tradition was carried on by his baby sister. Willie and his wife, Laura, also took great pride throwing the biggest cookouts with an extensive menu. He enjoyed entertaining family and friends. Willie was no stranger. He became a friend to whomever he came in contact with. He will be missed by all who knew him and loved him. Willie was preceded in death by his grandparents, Benny and Evie Strayhorn, his parents, Linter T. and Lucy May Virginia Morgan, his brother, Joe Linter Morgan, daughter and son, Leah and Dante Morgan. Willie is survived by his loving wife of 56 plus years, Lara Morgan, his son Derek Morgan, daughters Juanita and Danielle Morgan, four grandchildren, Shyandria Pitts, Cara Morgan, Derek Morgan, and Darius Morgan, three great-grandchildren, Jordan and Jada Pitts, and Liana Morgan, three sisters, Evelyn Carter, Doris and Charles Love, and his baby sister, Janice Morgan, special uncle, Benny Frank, a host of nieces and nephews, his special friends, Jay Lewis, Charles Estelle, and Eric Baldwin. This concludes my time, and I want to say thank you to Sister Morgan and Danielle for allowing me the opportunity. And to all the family, thank you for sharing such a wonderful man with all of us, and more so to me, sharing him with my family for 40 plus years. We love you. We're praying for you. We're praying with you.
Amen.
God bless you. Now that's living. Now we have remarks, please, by Jay Lewis, Deacon Baldwin, and Brother Johnson Sr., and then we have his daughter, Danielle. And so if you can please give Danielle one of your minutes, that would be great. Amen. You can come in that order.
To the Morgan family, Pastor Hines, and the other friends and guests that are here today, I am the name Jay Lewis you see on this paper. I'm Jay Lewis Nance, and I bring you greetings from many of James' relatives that are still living in the hometown, small town we grew up in, and they were all sent their greetings. And on this day, April 13, we'll gather significant numbers to commemorate the life and the passing from this life of one Willie James Morgan. I am one of those that are here today from some distance because I've known him for all of my life as he has known me. Our lives have been entwined by a closeness that has been unbroken. We have shared closeness that included family, included marriages, education, and religion. My father, I was pastor baptized James and Laura in the town of Gates, Tennessee, and most all of the members there in our age group. As he pastored there from 1944 until 1995. And we grew up with two primary social centers. That was the church and the school. And we had James and his brothers in this small farm town where everyone worked. And they were the two that we joked the most about working the hardest. And they worked. And James was a fast learner. And I think that's how he became who he really was. He was a giver. And the biblical reference that he who has much to give, much is expected. And he contributed to the lives of a lot of people, including mine. Even though I spent some 30 years away from home in the military, with the exception of overseas duties, I can't think of a year that I did not see James Morgan at least once, maybe twice, because we both returned home. We stayed knitted to that family, and we were always in and out. And now we are here to bid farewell to this husband. James has lived a nearly solid life. We reached adulthood in the presence of grandparents, parents, our children. He's the father. He was a husband, a father, grandfather, and a great-grandfather, the centerpiece of six generations. And 80 years is 10 years past, 70. And we were fortunate. We were blessed to have that much of him being who he was in our life for that period of time. And Laura, I love your spirit from the time you called me early morning after he passed away. And to his family, I want you to know that we are blessed for having had him in our lives for this long. We are going to be better persons. We are better persons for having known him. And I thank you for allowing me to stand here and speak today and represent so many people who were personal, close friends of James Morgan. And may God bless us all. Thank you.
Good morning, family. Good morning, all. Pastor Hines, my friends in ministry, in the pulpit. To the family, my scripture befittingly comes out of James 1:5. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally and unbraideth not, and it shall be given. I'm gonna use my two minutes wisely. I wanna make sure that I acknowledge all of you that worked with Willie or fished with Willie during our tenure. Stand up just quickly up and a quick down. Y'all look around and see who we touched the lives of fishing and working and all kinds of things we did. All right. Have your seat. Now, if you knew anything about Willie and myself, I'm going to use some some movie references and some song references to kind of bring us all back on in. If you saw the movie Forrest Gump, you knew that that Forrest had a good friend, and that would be Bubba. Willie would greet me every time, "Hey, Bubba." That was our thing. He would always call me Bubba. And if you knew the movie, they became best friends. They would go shrimp boat fishing. And they talked about all the different varieties of shrimp. You got all kinds of shrimp, tiger shrimp, dog shrimp, all kinds of shrimp during that movie. That was me and Willie on the boat all the time. Now, if you got close to Willie and you said something that he liked, he said, "Hush, boy." That was Willie. He was unique all by himself. And he had a way, I'm sure y'all got some sayings that he coined with y'all. But those are the two of the ones that stuck out with me. And as we got to fishing out there on the boat, Brother Tom Brown would come out there with us, and we'd invite us to his home, and I'd always bring my Bose radio. Because we like music. So when Laura called me and said, I heard her tell my wife that Willie had gone, I went to 1964, a Bobby Lewis song. It said, "I could sleep it all last night." Because I was tossing and turning. And y'all, I see y'all nodding your head, y'all know about Bobby Lewis. That was a great song. Great song. But as we fished, y'all know Willie liked to eat while he's fishing. So, Willie always have his cooler with us out there. And in the cooler would be watermelon, sardines, fruit, crackers, everything we'd have to sustain. And him and Tom would eat them sardines all day. I didn't like sardines.
Have mercy.
But I allowed them, you know, "Try these, boy. Try this." "No. You go ahead." I didn't enjoy sardines. But I enjoyed hanging out with them boys out in that water. So when in Rome, you do what the Romans do. So I tried one. And I'm okay with that. I tried it out of obedience. Because, you know, they tell you that biblically, you seek out some elders around you to gain wisdom. So I sought out Willie. Well, he sought me. I don't know what had happened, but we came together and we became good friends. Another song that we enjoyed, and I'm going to close with this. I used to be able to sing this back in my hooting days. I can't say it, but I'm just going to say the words. So the song is by James Cleveland. And I said, he stood on the banks of Jordan. Watching that ship go by. And when he did that, I think, Lord, the song says, I got my ticket. Don't leave me down here. Willie got his ticket. I'm going to see that ship go by. But he forgot something. He forgot something. And when y'all closed the box, I forgot to get up. He forgot his hooks. His hooks. He can't fish without hooks. You got to have some hooks if you're going fishing. So, Miss Laura, I'm going to get hooks to you. And Darius, stop casting all the time. Let the float sit till they catch the fish. We're going to keep fishing. Y'all pray for me as I pray for you. God bless you. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
First, giving it unto God.
Pastor Hines, to the pulpit, and to all of you, family and friends. I stand before you today, Brother Kedrill Johnson, Sr., as the chairman of the trustee ministry. You've read that Brother Morgan was a member of the trustee ministry, but that's not how I met him. So, but before I go with that, if we could have the trustees to stand up. You've probably seen them walk, standing around in their purple shirts. Some have some dual roles. Thank you. So as I said, when I met him, you know, most people who are older than me think I'm not as old as I am. And most of the younger kids think I'm older than I really am. You know, so, but when I met Brother Morgan, or Rock as I knew him then, and let me read my scripture that goes with this, John 15 and 13, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. So, when I met him, I was having a little issue with my motorcycle, and he looked at me like, you're too young to be riding a motorcycle. You know, and then the issue I had, he offered one of his at the time. You know, and we didn't really know each other, but the circuit that we ran in, that's just what we do. You know, and later that I learned that later that night, we were at another function, and the person that was DJing, and he's sitting back there, I'm not going to call his name, he had to step out, and he's like, hey, do this for me until I get right back. And I had never told anybody I knew anything about DJing, you know, so, but when I played this particular song, when I saw Brother Morgan and Sister Morgan, the first ones out on the dance floor, I knew that I must have been doing all right. You know, and he looked at me, turn it up! You know, and, you know, so.
What was the name of the song?
I can't remember, Pastor.
Good answer.
I have no recollection.
Boy, you do well.
But later did I know I would be here. We got to Michigan. I was only supposed to be here 2 years, and here it is 16 years later. And we met each other again, and we were here at Lilly. And when I got put in position as the chairman of the trustee ministry, you know, he, of his age, you know, would always give me a little advice here and there, and told me that whatever I needed him to do, he would do. I fought myself for not asking him to do more because I thought I was looking out for him. But little did I know that was, you know, he liked to work. You know, and our last conversation with him at the church, I told him I was interested in getting a boat, and I wanted him to go with me. And then I told him, well, why don't you just give me your boat and you go buy another one? You know. But he told me that I will go with you to get your boat, but you're going to spend your money, and I might charge you to go with you. Yeah. So to the family, thank you. He's going to be missed. He's going to be missed. And again, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for a friend.
Amen. Praise God.
I bet y'all looking, giving honor to God. Pastor Hines, Sister Hines, and the clergy in the building. I bet y'all looking like, now what's she going to get up here and say? We ain't heard her say nothing since Easter speech.
Amen.
Well, to be honest, I couldn't wait to get up here to talk about my dad. My scripture reading is coming from, where did my notes go? Oh, okay, let's go. My scripture reading is coming from Psalms 23 and 1. This is my dad's favorite scripture. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Now let's translate this. What he's saying is, all I need in my life is you meaning God, yes. Plus what you choose to give me. The shepherd's job is to provide the physical needs of his sheep. We are his sheep. Today I wanted to share with you the seven greatest qualities of my dad. The first quality is that he was God-fearing. He accepted Christ early in his life. We all accepted Christ early in our life. Sometimes we veer off, but I encourage you, as well as myself, get in a good Bible-based church. For the most part, during the pandemic, well, in the pandemic, I was watching church online. It's a big difference in actually attending church versus watching it online, like it is for working at home remote versus going into work. Sometimes you need to go.
I know.
So that's something that I'm definitely going to work on. The last time, well, I'll say the second to the last time I came to church, my mom and my dad were here. They always sit together. When my dad seen me walk in church, he came and sat by me. He said, what didn't happen?
Boy, y'all killing me.
I said, Dad, I just came to church. I'm good. He said, okay. So the second quality I want to share with you is that my dad was my hero. My dad was our whole family's hero. There was nothing that he couldn't do. The whole family thought it. My mom, my siblings, his sisters, even his mom and dad, even the nieces and nephews and aunts and uncles. Also, my dad was a great provider. I never seen our family go without. We always lived in a house. We always had cable. Everybody today is like, hey, let's get this, what do they call it? That little stick or whatever it's called. I said, I don't think I can live with that. My dad had cable for me, so I gotta have cable. We always had nice clothes, the newest toys, the latest shoes, all of that. My dad was a great provider. To save for retirement. Also with the credit cards, he basically told me, yeah, you're going to catch that sale and you're going to put on that card, but how you going to pay for it? Because if you're not paying for it in 30 days and you paying it off in 2 years, you buying that shirt over and over and over and over again.
Teach that.
So, and he would tell me, Danielle, sometimes you need to just sit down, stay at home, stay out them stores, you and your mama.
Yeah, I'm killing me. Woo.
The last quality that he taught me, I didn't catch on to this for a long time. He taught me how to tithe. Now, my attendance is not good. I catch church online. I even watch Joel Austin. But he taught me how to tithe. Being young and in my older days, I'm thinking, like, how are you giving $100 and $200 and $1,000 to, how do you do that? I have to pay my bills. Like, how do you do that? And if I finally caught on, it's a mindset. That's right. When you get yourself in that right mindset, you can do anything that you put your mind to do. And once I started doing it, I can't attest for anyone else, but once I started doing it, things changed for me. All right. And when I say things changed for me, financially things changed for me. I mean, through the roof, astronomical. My dad spoke things into existence for me. He was only telling me right. And it was late when I caught on, but thank God I caught on. And not to mention that that was the only man in my life, the only man in my life that believed in me. This past 2 weeks has been like a bad dream. But I'm here to tell you today that my dad's work is done. He's in heaven now. I know he's in heaven. Dad, I will always be your daughter. You will never leave my heart. And I promise to take good care of your queen, my mom. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Daniel.
God bless you. Now we have a solo by Lady Leck Hines, please.
Praise the Lord, saints. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Jesus told his disciples, "You believe, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." Amen. Yeah, said Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
How I love. Oh, yes, I do.
Calling your name.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
My Jesus.
Jesus.
Every day.
Your name is the same.
When my trouble surrounded me, I didn't have to despair. 'Cause you told me, Jesus, you would be right there. Seems like all my problems had just begun, but I don't have to worry about it, 'cause they have already been won. Yeah, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
How I love.
How I love.
Oh, yes, I do.
Calling your name.
Yeah, Jesus.
Jesus.
My Jesus.
Jesus.
Every day. Your precious name.
Your name is the same.
I remember the time I felt so all alone. When I needed you, Jesus, all I had to do was call. Sometime in the morning, sometime late at night. But when I got up off of my knees, everything was all right. Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
My rose, I'm sharing, Jesus.
Jesus.
How I love.
How I love.
Oh, yes, I do.
Calling your name.
Yeah, Jesus.
Jesus.
My mountain mover, Jesus.
Jesus.
My many of the valley.
Every day. Your name is the same.
Yeah. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus.
How I love.
Yes, I do.
Calling your name.
Yeah, Jesus.
Jesus.
I'm above my Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, every day. Your name
is the same. Yeah.
Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on, Jesus. Come on,
Jesus. Jesus.
Said, I love.
How I love calling your name.
God bless you, saints. Saints, there's power in the word.
Yes.
There's comfort in the word.
Yes.
There's deliverance in the word. There's strength in the word of God. So we thank God for our pastor, Pastor Hines, who's going to deliver the word of God. Let us receive him by saying, Pastor Hines.
Pastor Hines.
Come on, put your hands together for the Lord. Oh, yeah, he's worthy. I said he's worthy. Oh, yeah. Let the redeemed say so. They that trust in the Lord shall not be made ashamed. You may have your seat in the presence of the Lord. In the honor of my beloved brother and friend, Brother Willie James Morgan, to his family, love you, and thank God for his life.
Yes. Yes.
And to Sister Morgan, that's personal, me and her know what that means. To the Estelle family.
Yes.
God bless you. To his beloved friend, Charles Estelle.
Yes.
To Brother Eric Baldwin and the Baldwin family.
Yes.
Let me cut back over to the Estelles. God gave me both kinds. Brother Morgan, hard worker. Brother Estelle, supervisor. The Lord gave me both kinds.
Praise God.
I shall never forget the Malibu. Late Brother Morgan had got himself in a fix. And Charles Estelle was the union rep. And they thought they had something on Brother Morgan, but they told Charles Estelle. And he went and said, Brother Morgan, don't tell nobody, but they don't have you. And so Brother Morgan went into the meeting and says, Charles Estelle told me y'all don't have me. They both came to the church. Pastor, what we gonna do about him? I said, you couldn't keep it, so why you thought he was gonna keep it? And I can hear Brother Morgan in heaven. Charles Astell told me it's some gold streets up here. And so I just thank God for friendship.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of folk can't stay friends. Because you know why? Because they waiting on that person to always prove the friendship.
Well, yeah.
I have a friend, we hold a state record together. I pray every year at the state finals, it don't get broke. It's an indoor mile relay record. They broke the outdoor relay record, but the only way this record stays, they don't run the race anymore. And so I'm a lifetime record holder.
All right.
But there is a man by the name of Colonel Richard Nash.
Yes.
He would always see me and say, Hines, you made me famous. I go, what are you talking about? He said, man, we're in the record books. I said, no, we famous. Richard sends a check here every month just to me to do God's will.
Thank you, God. Yeah.
He said, Hines, they don't pay you enough. And I said, what? He says, I'm putting my life on the line in the flesh. And you putting your life on the line in the spirit.
All right.
And so for the last 30 years, Colonel Richard Nash sends me a check for $400 a month. And he associates that back to something that happened in 1979.
All right.
At a track meet.
All right.
I used to tease my son. I says, you don't have the kind of friends I got. He said, what? I says, I haven't did anything great for Richard since 1979.
Mm. Well.
But he's still holding on to what happened 1979.
Yeah.
At Western Michigan University.
All right. All right.
And I want to say, that's how you ought to be friends. Some of y'all hold on to friendship, what you did right now.
Yeah.
Validate if we're going to be friends tomorrow. That's what keeps me in love. I don't count on what you're doing today.
That's right.
I hold on to what happened back then.
Yeah, yeah.
It'll help y'all. I said all that. That Brother Morgan, two things before I get in the message. Because I don't know how the Holy Spirit going to direct this, but I want to say this. He's the first member that ever gave me
$1,000.
All right. Mm-hmm. All right.
1988.
Thank the Lord.
Brother Morgan found out that they didn't give me my installation offer. Brother said to me, you wasn't worth it.
Have mercy.
And Brother Morgan, the next Sunday, came up and gave me 10 $100 bills.
Amen.
Now, at 25, 26, $1,000, I was like, oh, I didn't hit the lotto. And you got to be careful if you say stuff like that by Brother Morgan, because he'll go, what's that number? Now, y'all can say what you want to. I know he was a tither, so if he hit the lotto, we hit the lotto. Right, come on, shake your hand. Some of y'all so sanctified, you ain't no heaven good. My man, Brother Morgan. And God would just bother me about Brother Morgan. And sometimes I didn't want to bless him, but God cared for him.
Yes.
I have a truck, and I love my truck. Mm-hmm. And people would stop me. Sell me your truck. I said, my truck ain't for sale.
Right.
And one day I pulled up in the driveway, and the Spirit says, give that truck to Brother Morgan.
Mm-hmm.
I went in the house and said, Dean, you know what the Holy Spirit said? Let's touch and agree if that's the Spirit. Now, I done everything else by myself in the Spirit, but when it came to my truck, I walked in this church. I said, Brother Morgan, the Lord told me to give you this truck.
Showed it. I'm a witness.
I didn't want to give my truck to him. He said, boy, let God use you. I'm going to tell you, Sister Morgan, what's his is yours.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Thank you, God.
I'm joking to try to.
Yes, bless him, Jesus. Bless him, Lord. Bless him, Jesus.
Looking at that man there, Charles Arnold, was the anchor. Help me stay the course.
That's right, Pastor.
But the Morgans and the Browns and the Estelles was the sail.
All right.
When the Holy Spirit blew.
All right. Glory to God.
You know, God, I'm getting closer to this old girl because we driving down the highway. Other day, I said, girl, I see the exit. She said, what you talking about? I said, I see the exit. I used to couldn't see the exit. But I'm going to be getting off soon.
My God, my God.
These services are mile markers.
Yes, yes. Yes, Lord.
I'd have never thought you'd have outlived him.
All right. That's right.
Look what 92 looked like loving God. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, Lord.
See, them type of men, they just don't make anymore.
Amen.
I'm telling you, I take a church engagement and bus pull up and I'm running because, you know, life happens when you plan it.
Yes, 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 Lord.
I'm telling you, it just happens. Get on the bus, crowd of folk, we're going to Detroit. I'm worried about everybody don't cook right. You know, what we going to eat when we get over there? Brother Morgan and Sister Morgan have coolers of sandwiches, drinks, and Supervisor Charles Estelle would say, Irene sent this fruit tray. And I'm like, Sister Estelle, sick. She's been up all night. Erica, cut this. Donovan.
Well,
them kind of.
Yes, Lord.
Now, I don't know what the next pastor going to get.
My God.
But I thank God I got this.
Yeah.
The late A.P. Williams said something to me. I was giving pastors when I first was unveiling the church. I had it locked up. I said, I want y'all to come in and see what the Lord has done. And we pray. And A.P. Williams said something to me, I'd never forget. He said, boy, you're good, but the Lord sends you a better class of people.
All right. All right.
See, them kind of folk, you don't get it done without them.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Don't fool yourself.
Amen. Yes.
You, I tell young preachers all the time, you can talk about you leading folk. If you look behind you and ain't nobody following, you just taking a walk.
Well.
I look up, small church in Benton Harbor, Brother Morgan be right there.
That's right. Thank you, God.
He told the preacher one time, and I was like, Brother Morgan, kind of. He said, y'all just want to pay Pastor Hines $75. Take up an offering. I got $100. And he told me, he said, you ain't got to worry about them folk. You know, yeah, I'm going to talk like Brother Moore. By God, you ain't their pastor. They just babysitters. You, I, he called me, you, I, baby. We got to rock you.
Well.
And that's how Brother Morgan would talk to. And I found out, he never cussed. Not around me, he used words like, by garment. I'm still trying to figure out, what is that? He might fuss at you, but he'll brag on you.
He
would tell me, you know why I go to this church? I said, because the Lord sent you. No, because you can preach. I said, thank you, Brother Morgan. He said, you know, I'm waiting on the end of the sun. I said, get your rest, Brother Morgan. I know where I could find it. Some of y'all I'm looking for. Let's hurry up and get through this. It's such a beautiful day. This has been a long 2 weeks on Mother.
Yeah.
2 weeks, that's 15 days. And it's going to be longer.
Yeah, it's longer.
The message God gave it to me, I was coming from a funeral. All right. And I was tired. I was on 94, and the lines in the highway was moving. Mm-hmm. And I pulled over to get some water. And I said to my wife, you got to drive or we got to sleep. I said, you drive to Battle Creek and we'll switch and I'll take it in. Well, Battle Creek became 1919 Briar Creek. When I woke up, we was in our driveway. But while I was in that gas station, I got a call at 8:21 p.m. from Brother Willie James Morgan. I didn't know it because my phone was in the car and I was trying to get water to wake up. When Sister Hines pulled me in the driveway and woke me up and said, we're here, she said, Sister Morgan have called a couple of times. I said, it must be emergency because it's about 9:30. I said, call. And I found out the news. Brother Morgan had gone in. I knew from the voicemail and the timestamp that I had to be one of the last people he talked to or wanted to talk to before God called him in. Mm-hmm. I get close to 100 messages a day. I didn't look at my phone. Just, I wore down, I was tired, I was coming out of a funeral, and I found out one of the better members had died. Yeah, it's such a thing as better members.
Amen. Amen.
You cause that, Emeritus Chairman of Trustee Ministry. I must have been in my fifth year, and I didn't know the members well, and one died, and I called Deacon Charles Arnold, he said, come out to the house. And I went out to the house, and he said, well, you got some members that are assets and some of them liability. He said, this is a liability. Mm-hmm. And you handle liability people different.
That's right.
Than you handle assets.
That's right.
Hey, you might not like that, but I'm from Benton Harbor, not Parkside or, you know, in Jackson, everybody get a trophy, just participation. Mm. In Benton Harbor, you got to win. Craziest thing I ever heard. He don't come to practice, miss two games, and you get last place, and you get a first place trophy? All right. What y'all teaching here?
See.
John 20:13. Just got good memories looking at you.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something. Get beyond how you got there and enjoy where you at.
All right, all right.
I'm saying this to you all. Something have happened to me to make me mature to understand God moves people And sometimes he have to cause a situation to move you.
Amen. Amen.
To get you where Amen. He's going to Amen. Develop you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Everybody don't shake hands and say goodbye. I liken it to 37 years ago, Sister Hines joined the church. I was preaching. She walked down the aisle. She joined Little Missionary Baptist Church. She was crying in the church. And like, look at the spirit move. I said, that girl crying, she didn't want to join this church. She didn't want to be in Little Missionary Baptist Church on Dio Alley. She came from the other side of the tracks. But she was just being loyal. She must have believed that song, Deacon Baldwin. How that song go? Something about, you know it, Deacon Baldwin. I know you know it.
I can't remember.
How it go, Sister Hines? Honor your man, love your man. There you go. I knew somebody was a sinner around here. Stand by your man. I tell my children all the time, I was a church baby. She was the club woman. Thank God for the club and the church. That's how they got here. You got to stop holding hands at some time to get children here. Woo, Reverend, did I take my medicine? And they said unto her, woman, why weepeth thou? She said unto them, because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they lay him. For a brief moment, in a little while, the grass withered and the flowers faded away. But the word of God endureth to all generations. For a brief moment, in a little while, I want to preach to you this message, the Holy Spirit, when the loss become personal. When the loss become personal. I said to my wife, I said, set the clock 7:30, because it's just flooding in my mind. I got to write it down. Because I'm messing up watching the Lakers. And I got to see if Golden State get beat by the Suns.
Well.
So my Lakers could have a chance.
Well.
I said, Brother Morgan, this is just like you. Will say goodbye in the midst of my enjoyment.
Well.
Sat now. You my guy, I'm counting on to make sure the contractor build the new brick garbage dump. See, I don't care how sharp the pastor is, he still got to be handicapped. So he depends on God.
All right.
See, when you get so gifted, that you ain't looking for help, you've already too arrogant.
Yeah.
God ought to talk me, let the people help you. Some of them are brighter than you. I married somebody. I had children. They brighter than me. Let me tell you, I know I'm brighter than them. I pay all the bills, give them all the money, and they say thank you, and I feel good about doing it. Now, them some pretty bright folk who can pimp you out like that.
I
wish somebody helped me.
Well,
oh, I'm sorry, maybe that's too ungodly word for y'all. Take care. Where I'm from, that's pimping. They said unto her, woman, why weepeth thou? our text takes us first to a scene of crucifixion.
Well.
And reminds us of Jesus' finished work on the cross.
Yes.
We are ushered. There go Brother Morgan, an usher. I couldn't believe they let Brother Morgan be an usher. I still haven't figured it out. Brother Morgan was a nice and kind man, but he didn't always stay focused on the task. Now, if you know him, you know him. But we ushered here in this text into the garden.
Yeah.
I wish I had Bible readers, Bible study, and praise God for you.
Come on.
In your testimony of transformation. They done crucified him. They done buried him. And he has risen. But everybody don't know he's risen. There's a sister, the main character of the text, Mary Magdalene. She's devoted. And she's not going because she believes he is risen. She's gone because she's committed. To really anoint his body, because he's a dead Messiah.
Some
folk, if things ain't going their way, if it ain't live, they finish with it. Sometimes God puts you in a dead situation. I tell folk all the time, be careful what you're talking about a church, why you don't go. Because he still is the author and finisher of our faith. And everything ain't got to go the way I wanted. I learned that about year 20. I thought everybody, and the members, the older I get, the better they helping me get prepared for heaven. Now Timmy said, boy, don't get so bothered by that. You used to be that way. Everybody ain't got to be faithful. Everybody ain't got to be committed. Just thank God they in it. I'm trying to help some of y'all that's pastoring. Just love the folk for what God send you. And stop grading the folk. That ain't our job, brother. Another great man messed around and said, you rebels, and he missed the paradise. And I just tell folk, if you thought enough to send me somebody who didn't like me, thank God you sent them. But the Morgans in life, boy, I tell you, he makes it worth the journey. I wish you knew what I'm talking about here. Mary's got grief, but Laura got grief. I want to call her Shane, but that's her motorcycle name. And I keep telling y'all, I'm like Brother Morgan. Charles shouldn't have told him what they said and didn't want him to keep it. You shouldn't have told me your name was Shane. Laura and Mary Magdalene, they got some grief problems. The resurrection narrative is written in the book of John especially. Mary Magdalene is in all of the Gospels, but in John, he highlights her. Laura is in every part of Willie James Morgan's life, from high school in Gadsden, Tennessee, to Jackson, Michigan, especially Jackson, Michigan, from Plymouth, Chidhawk, to Deering Road. I started pastoring in 88, and their son passed in 89, And Brother Morgan came over to the church to say, would you do the honors in burying my son? And I said, I want to come to your house. And when I got to the house on Chittock, I walked up a ramp. This is something about this family that you need to know. In their grieving and loss, they thought about benefiting the church. Amen. Brother Morgan said to me, Pastor, my son is and was in a wheelchair, and he will no longer need the ramp. He said to me, do you think the church, who is not handicapped accessible, can be handicapped accessible to parents like me and Morgan, or Laura one day could bring our child to church? And I said, yes. And we had the funeral. And the next week, Brother Morgan had taken the ramp out and was putting it in the church. And for years, folk walked in the old church up the ramp and didn't know that that was pain and sorrow. Every time they go up the ramp, they have to remember who the ramp was built for. That's why I said to my friend, Reverend Davis, and I told Deke, go get his son-in-law and get him up here and sit beside him. Because he's here to honor their family, but it's ripping open a wound that has not healed. That's why the message this day is called When Loss Become Personal. And if you don't watch yourself, if you connected when somebody else died, it'll take you back there.
Yeah.
All right. And time don't always fix stuff.
Yeah.
Says, Brother Morgan and Sister Morgan, now living on Deering Road.
Yeah.
It's hard to weave together the life of people, but it was not for James or Willie James Morgan. Because when I met him and he left me, he was the same person from day one.
Yeah.
He worked hard and he played hard.
Yeah.
He loved Laura. He loved his family.
Yeah.
Loved his friends. And he bragged on his pastor. That's who Brother Willie Morgan was to me. But the most important thing, he loved God. Brother Morgan loved God. When his mother was alive, he would leave out of here driving to go see her. He'd always come by my house and said, pray with me that I could look on my mother. He would always ask about my mother. When my son got beaten, we was in the courtroom, Brother Morgan showed up 5 hours away. He walked into the church or to the courtroom with his trustee ministry shirt on. And at lunch break, 500 officers showed up because Brother Morgan came in like he was a gang. They was going to keep peace and order. You know, Brother Morgan come in talking loud.
Yeah.
And I'm saying, Brother Morgan, he said, boy, we going to do, no, don't say we going to do something. Because I ain't not ending up like my son.
Yeah.
I surrender.
Yeah.
I said, he loved God. To his wife, I say, the Lord is still able.
Yeah.
To his daughters, I leave the words of Christ. As he said, daughter, behold your mother.
Yeah.
Honor thy mother and father,
yeah,
and your days will be long.
Yeah.
and it would be well with ye. Yeah. To James' sisters, Evelyn the oldest, Doris the middle, and Janice the youngest, or should I say baby, I give you the words of God. I will not have you to be ignorant, sisters, concerning those who are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others who have no hope. Jesus is good into speaking to sisters. There was two other sisters one day. Sorrow had got in their spirit. But he said to them, I know you lost your brother, but remember these words. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he was dead, yet shall he live. To friends, I say like Job, if a man shall die, shall he live again? I said to you in the opening part of the message, Brother Morgan called and left me a voicemail at 8:21 p.m. Thursday, March the 28th, right before he died. And he said in that unique voice of Willie Morgan, y'all got to know how I talk. Pastor Hines, this is Willie Morgan. Like I don't know who's talking to me. I got a question to ask you. And the conversation ended. I don't know what he was going to ask me. And I don't know what I was going to tell him. But I surely was going to pray about it before I respond. Yes, this loss is personal. But none as personal to Mrs. Morgan. Over 50 years of marriage, 56 and some months to be exact, and 60 years of loving James. Somebody ought to say glory to the Lamb. What God, therefore, God has joined together, let no man put asunder. But death can put a pause in it. But it is not the end of the story. Mary Magdalene. I said Mary Magdalene. She was with some other women. And they came to anoint Jesus' body. They was worrying about who was going to move the stone. You know, sometimes stuff can happen in your life. And you already got one mountain to climb. But you think about what mountain is before you to even get to the mountain you got to climb. Come on, go here with me. Them sisters had know that they had killed their Savior and they was going to the tomb, but they remember that they had rolled a stone in their way. But I got news for you. He's still rolling stones away. Have mercy. Yeah, it might be dark tomorrow, but he still is the bright and morning star. That's the leverage we have in a situation like this. The Lord is still able. But I tell you, it's still personal. But I tell you, when they got there, they found the stone rolled away. It wasn't rolled away for Jesus to get out. It was rolled away for them to get in. Lord trying to get you in. There's some stuff trying to keep you from the church. But the Lord is trying to get you in while he can show you he's risen. I wish somebody help me. You know, the old church would help you get your way in. You know, this young church now, you almost got to throw water on them. But wet wood don't burn, children. We need some of that old dry wood. Yeah. How do you get dry? Them that's dependent on the Lord. Yeah. Those who tell of his goodness. Yeah. Those who've been sick and now well. Yeah. Those who've been left out but now have been included. Yeah. That's some dry wood. Yeah. Yeah. It don't take an organ to get you there. It don't take your preacher to get you there. It takes your own testimony. Somebody gonna know what I'm talking about. All that good. I said that's all good. Yeah, when I was a boy, I'd be like Brother Morgan, I get in when that organ get to kicking. Ain't nothing like that Hammond organ. When the drums get to playing, and when they get to hollering, I go to hollering. But grandmama, my daddy, I pastored his mother-in-law. My daddy would walk to the pulpit, and she already say a word, Joe. Yeah. Like, why is she hollering at it? She was on fire. She was just waiting. You know her, Stane. Oh, Grandma Grant, she was on fire before she got in the church. Talking about the Lord brought a mighty long way. Yeah. See, some of you think you made it on your own. But old Brother Morgan, he stuck with the church. Yeah. I don't care how far he rode on his motorcycle. I don't care how many jobs took him away. He coming back. Because he knew the Lord. Yeah. Yeah. Lord, thank you. Yes. Laura, she was cooking, and old James was out working. Yeah. All right. It's getting late in the evening. Laura getting worried. Yeah. Yeah. But she know James. He coming home. Yeah. I wish somebody knew what I was talking about. He coming to the house, and you know old James, girl, what you cook? Yeah. Old Laura knew how to handle it. Some cabbage and potatoes. And he get to brag, oh, I'm going to eat up everything in you. You know, that's the way he flirting with her now. Oh, somebody help me here. Went on and took his shower. Look at Danielle said, look at her mama. The mama said, how you think you got here?
All right.
Oh, somebody help me here. Yes. Laura was cooking cabbage and potatoes. Waiting on James to clean himself up. Just like Mary, she took this mean when she wondering where he was at. She went to the bathroom door and couldn't get the door open. But when they got the door open, she discovered somebody had taken James away. Yeah, just like Mary, when she went to the tomb. She wasn't looking for a risen Christ. She went there and found that in her mind, somebody had taken him away. Mary, in the story, ran to tell Peter, and the Bible said that disciple that Jesus loved, that somebody had taken him away. In my case, that's what Laura did when she was calling me. Yeah. I was coming down the highway, but she couldn't connect with me. Yeah. But it reminded me of the song that the old church used to sing. Yeah. Operator, give me Jesus. Yeah. His line is never busy. Yeah. All right. Some of y'all need to go to the church and connect with what's being said. And what's being done? The old folk used to have a song, he may be not there when you want him, but he is always on time. Yeah, Laura discovered after the paramedics had got in that James was gone. Everybody need a shepherd. That's what Laura was doing when she was calling. I stop by to tell you, God will not give you one according to his heart if you don't need one. I know the young, bright, educated people think they can stay home and know God. But I stop by to tell you, God is the author of the program. They used to sing a song, he's too high for you to go over him. He's too low for you to go under. He's too wide for you to go around. But you must come in at the door. He says, narrow is the way. You got to follow the way God tells us to go. Brother Morgan was a man that believed the way God said go. Brother Morgan wasn't so much on fire for the Lord, but he knew that he had to stay close to the fire. He'd walk in and they would talk and fellowship with him in the vestibule. But soon as I'd get up, he'd cut off his conversation. He don't care what you're talking about. He don't care what you got to say. He was going to come on, get in on his pew. He thought he was on the morning bench. Some of y'all ain't old enough to know what that means. That means sit there till you get something. Brother Morgan would sit there till he got something. I wish somebody helped me this morning. That knew the power of God. Old Brother Morgan, somebody took him. And Laura was troubled by it. But ain't nothing new under the sun. Mary was looking for Jesus. But somebody had took him. She started this journey with other women. But she returned to the tomb by herself. Sometimes you have the privilege of traveling in this life with someone. But at the end of the day, you must return by yourself. I can hear the scripture say, we shall return back to the dust. I don't care how close we walk together. I'm trying to enjoy her. But I'm going to have to say bye and farewell soon, girl. But I tell you what the book said. The dead know nothing of this world. Don't weep for me, but weep for those who's left behind. Oh, Brother Morgan, he's been working on houses, but there's been another man working on mansions. I wish I had a witness here. I feel pretty good. I stopped by to tell you, when Mary got to the tomb was empty. It had compounded things because she was grieving. You got to watch grief. You can be talking to angels, but grief can confuse you. You can't see what God is doing, and you sometimes don't understand why the Lord did it. But I stopped by to tell you, all things work for the good. Can I get a witness here? The Lord, he working on your behalf. He's a good father. If you ask him for bread, he won't give you a stone. Anybody here ever seen God provide for you? He's a mighty good provider. He'll make a way out of no way. Won't it do it, children? Anybody here know he'll do it? He's still doing it. He neither sleep nor slumber. He's still doing it. I tell him, work, God. Just like James Morgan, he was working, but he fell asleep. But the God we serve, he don't fall asleep. He rock us to sleep. Can I get a witness? I heard if she wasn't so confused about her grief, she should have asked them, why y'all here and what you doing here? But she went right in to her loss. She said, I'm looking for him who had healed my body. I had seven demons, but the Lord set me free. And if the Lord done anything for you, you ought to be looking for him. Ask somebody, Do you know him? The man sent from Galilee. He raising the sick. Good God Almighty. I tell you, he feeding the hungry. If you talk here with me, I'm just a black Baptist preacher. I like to call and the response. If I say something and you agree with it, say something. You ought to be a witness. Good God Almighty. Old Brother Morgan, he'd be asleep until he hear me coming on in. And then old Morgan, he'd stand up like he'd been up. And he'd look at me and wave his hand. I wish I had somebody who knows about landing the plane. When you pull in and you land the plane, they got some folk out there telling the plane, come on in. That's what Brother Morgan, he was telling me, to come on in, but be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that he shall weep, Sunday after Sunday. Brother Morgan would tell me to come in, but one Thursday, the Holy Spirit told Brother Morgan, come on in. Y'all don't hear me. I heard, you got to look at the text. The Bible says in 20:2, when Mary first went to the grave, she went with other women. She ran up on him. She said to the angels, where have you laid him? For we was looking for him. But when she returned, sometime you got to come back by yourself, and it becomes personal. It's no longer we, but I. Where have y'all taken him? You got to look for God for yourself. Mama can't help you. Daddy can't help you. You got to find him for yourself. I heard they said to her, why are you weeping? Now look at the text. The Bible said Jesus was there too. He's always there. Can I get a witness? He said, woman, she looked at him, but the Bible said she didn't know who he was, but he called her by her name. He said, Mary. The Bible said she turned around and said, Jesus, I stopped by to tell you, old James Willie Morgan, he was going to take his shower. He was just a man, but the Lord God called his name. I said, yeah, when he called your name, you got to drop what you're doing. You can't finish what you started. You got to turn. I said, you got to turn. He turned. I heard, come on up. Yeah. It done got personal. Some of these feelings you can just do. But when it become a personal loss, it makes a difference. You don't hear me. I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same. Because it's personal now. That old crazy dark boy. He show up with his old bright skinned woman. My people in my old little town said, I said, Brother Willie Morgan died. They said, who is that? I said, it's that old dark skinned boy with that bright girl. They said, oh yeah, we know him. It came personal. Some of you ain't never coming to church till it become personal. My prayer is it become personal. The Lord had to get me down He had to make it personal. But I'll never see you again. I had a good journey. People like Brother Willie Morgan. Never miss the anniversary. Lord, I thank you for the good as well as the bad. But Lord, thank you for this old country boy. He never made me feel inadequate. He almost made me feel like I was better than I was. And Lord, I thank you for that. I thank you because he had the spirit of encouragement. I thank you both of our sons got in trouble. And Lord, you just good. I say you just good. He was troubled, but he would come on to church. Old Malibu went out of business. He said, Rabbit, I said, the Lord go bless you. Old Brother Morgan, when he turned 62, he got his Social Security check. He walked down and put it in my hand. He said, I want to give the Lord the first of whatever I get, Rabbit. I wish you knew what I was talking about. I'm talking about some kind of believer.
Yes.
Now, he talk crazy. He'll flirt with you, but he loved the Lord.
Yes.
I'm not lying. Mother Stella said, you ain't lying. Y'all need the Lord, children.
My God.
You need to not fool yourself. Jesus. You need to get to the church.
Yes.
You need to get to the church. I promised old House of Johnson I'd let you out at 1:25. The old secretary, she gonna come to see me and she gonna talk to my wife. I said, you you think you can tell that woman, don't nobody pass to me.
All right now, come on now.
Sister Hines looked at her and said, you don't know who I married.
Thank you, God.
Yeah, and I appreciate the friends, but I tell folks, stay in your lane. Mm. Stay in your lane. God know what he's doing. That man there, we went to Detroit, and they was acting crazy outside. And Brother Morgan walked right up to me. I said, Brother Morgan, you got a gun? He said, no, I got a hammer. He said, Reverend, more crimes have been committed with a hammer. Your daddy was crazy. I walked right with him. I told Sister Hines, go find Sister Morgan, because I'm with Brother Morgan. Because I'm going back home. We got on that bus, and I said, what we going to get to eat? He said, Reverend, don't worry about that. He pulled out this cooler. Yeah, look, a little deep. Now he said, wipe my nose. Yeah, why didn't you tell me that? Girl, you just looking at me, snot running down my face. What's your name?
Sierra.
Sierra, you need to come to church and tell the pastor to wipe his nose. Say that, wipe your nose.
Wipe your nose.
That's what's wrong with you sadiddy people. Wipe your nose. I need to blow my nose. Yeah, that's a Holy Ghost one there. Boy, we say everything on the Holy Ghost. Come stand up here with me, Darius.
Amen.
You wasn't a grandson, you was a son.
All right, yes.
Brother Morgan made me go to the track team. He said, Pastor Hines, don't you work with kids? I said, yeah, Brother Morgan. He said, go out there and stand by my grandson and make sure he act right. I came back and told Brother Morgan, your grandson crazy. He said, what you mean? I said, that boy is jumping on a pole going way up in the air. Don't he know that's for them people, not us? You remember me coming out there to track me?
Yeah, I do.
I looked at that boy. I said, he done got hit in the head with that hammer. Then you driving your car fast, you remember that? And hit that a tank. Yeah. Brother Morgan came down to church. He said, Pastor Hines, can I talk to you? I said, yeah. He said, I know you know everybody. He said, my grandson ran in somebody's yard and hit their tank. You think you know him? I said, who is it? He said, he lived over here. I said, oh, yeah, I know him. I called him. I said, hey, man, that's my grandson. Do not take him to court. Now, they didn't take you to court, but you know what? You about 6 years behind in tithes. Now shake my hand and say, I'm going to get it right, Pastor.
I'm going to get it right, Pastor.
Go have your seat. I got to come down.
Amen.
Folk tithes on their way to hell. You got to have the right spirit.
Amen.
I want to love all of y'all. To his half and buddies that thought they could play cards. Stand up. You know who I'm talking about. Brother Morgan brought him over to the church, said, Pastor Hines, this is the crookedest card dealer we got. I said, well, sit him down. I beat him so bad, he called his brother. We got to get this, Reverend. Have a seat and don't say nothing. We don't want to hear your side of it. What are you doing is part of healing. Laughing and crying.
My God.
Now I'm going to do what Sister Morgan would do. I was at her house. I said, now, she would be riding on a motorcycle and James would go too fast and she would get in front of James. Slow it down and stop. And that's what I was doing to her. And she's supposed to give me the signal. Come on in, Reverend. Want to love you. Now, we have a tremendous expression of display of taking his body in a horse-driven carriage.
Yes, yes.
Just way over the top, and cool. Great people deserve over the top.
Yes.
I want to say to you, love your mother.
Yes.
You know why God had to say that? Because he know they was going to get on our nerves. You know, mamas want to talk to you like you're the baby, and you got a baby.
All right.
And you know what? How I help my mother now? My mother is 96 years old, and sometimes she calls me, N.L. I say, yeah, ma. And sometimes she tells me, James, where the baby at? I said, oh, I got the baby right here. All I'm telling you is, I'm not trying to raise my mother. Mm-mm. She raising me. Mm-hmm. I'm just getting in her world and agreeing. I tell the people at the church here, I'm getting old, but don't misuse me when I'm old.
That's right.
Ask yourself this question, where did he get old?
Right, that's right. That's right.
Spirit came to me and said, well, you're going to be the Nick Saban, Reverend. I said, huh? He said, Alabama was good, but you made them better. Nick Saban last year, he's just riding around on the golf course. He had assistant coaches. Y'all coach.
That's right.
They're going to put me on TV and say, I won the game. And at some point when you go cutting up, I'm going to say bye. Mm. That's what happened to Nick Saban. He lost to Michigan and the folk acted so bad, he said bye. Now watch where they go. Because they didn't understand how to appreciate the man who built it. Mm. There's no great house without a great man. Mm. When I ride out there on Deering Road,
that's right.
I go, wow. Mm.
patio, extended garage, backyard. You know, that's the kind of place we used to say, party over here, party over there. That's what that looked like. But I know that wasn't always out there.
That's right.
It took.
That's right.
You ain't getting that without them. Now, the key to life is like I tell my kids. I see my son here. Thank you. Santa's favorite son. I gave him some money one time. I told my wife, send him in the bedroom. I said, Joe, I'm going to give you your inheritance while I'm alive. You have to keep standing, Joe. Yeah, keep standing. Yeah, that's the pastor. He can stand when he wants to. He's 85. Where did he grow?
Okay.
Among the people of God.
All right.
And I gave Joe this money, and he said to me, what you want me to do with it? I said, let me tell you something. It was easier for me to make it, but it's going to be harder for you to keep it. See, the people who don't earn it don't know all of the struggle.
My God, listen.
When you just get it, it seems like everybody just give it to you. Mm. But if you really want to fulfill something, protect it.
Yes.
You hear what I'm telling you?
Yes.
Yes, Pastor.
Say it now.
Thank you.
Amen.
Come on, give, Pastor.
Amen.
I was going to make you talk, Joe, but the pastor spoke in front of you.
Amen.
Tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
Have you seen? Love you. Come on, let's bring the mortician in. Come on there. Now, I got a dilemma. I got a cousin that owns a mortician. But, Lin Ting, get him to fix me, but send me down to Washington. I want to look my best. Don't you want to look your best? Folk putting makeup on you that you didn't buy. Y'all know some makeup we can't wear. Boy, touch my skin. Boy, touch my skin. Now, you remember I was smooth, brother. Somebody say smooth.
Smooth.
Oh, yeah. Love all of you. You come down here. Come down here. Turn around. Turn around. Yeah. He'll never forget this experience. He said, I went to that church and they were calling everybody down. What's your name?
Doug Bloom. Yes.
What church you go to?
Jackson Free Methodist.
Ooh, who is that? Wait a minute. But who was before Jason? He's a prayer warrior.
Tom Raimondo.
Yes, Tom Raimondo. You come by this church sometime. What time you get out of church?
We get out of church about 12:30.
Yeah, we just getting started. We'll see you. Yeah. You come on, give our honorary member a hand. Now look, this how we do it here. All right. Love you. You ready, my friend? Can we get the pallbearers, preachers? Oh, flower ladies first. Is that what? Who bought all these flowers? Yeah, I'm just bringing a point. Thank God for the expression of love.
Yes.
Yeah, give her two. She can take two. Give her two. Y'all can take two, you young people. Hey, we got a whole side over here. Thank you, thank you. Come on. Don't y'all make me do like I did to brother from a Free Methodist. Come on down.
Hear my home going.
Oh, yeah.
Don't worry about me. Just another soldier going on with.
Yeah, come down the middle aisle and we're going to give you the flowers to take them right back out to the vehicle.
Hear my home going. Don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. I'm just another soldier.
Yes.
Going on.
You got
the
two children, boy Michael.
When you hear my home going,
I'll see you Sunday at 12 o'clock.
Don't worry about me.
I'll see you Sunday at, everybody say 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock. Don't let her get out of here. And all you have to do, walk right back down this aisle.
When you hear my home going.
Yeah, I didn't take my
medicine. Don't worry about me. I'm just Paul another Bearers. Soldier going home with the Lord.
Preachers,
when
come on up front.
When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me.
Will you stand, please?
I'm just another soldier going on with the Lord. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. When you hear my home going, don't worry about me. I'm just another soldier going home with the Lord. Again, one thing I know, sure been Lord, born again.
Lord is my shepherd.
One thing
I shall
I know,
not want. Maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters.
He
restores
going home with the Lord.
He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
For
thou art with me.
Don't worry
thy
about
rod
me.
And thy staff, they comfort me.
When you hear my
thou prepares a table
going.
Before me.
Don't worry
in the presence
about
of
me.
Mine enemies. Thou anoints
I'm
my
just
head with oil.
Soldier.
My cup runs
going
over.
Home with the Lord.
Surely goodness and mercy.
One thing I
shall
know.
Follow me all the days of my life.
Sure been born
and
again.
I shall dwell in the house of the Lord.
One
forever.
Thing that I know.
Blessed is the man that
shall
walketh not in the counsel
again.
Of the ungodly, nor stands in the
one
way of the sinners,
know,
nor sits in the seat of the scornful.
Shall be born again.
For his delight is in the law of the
I'm
Lord.
Just another soldier.
And in his law doth he meditate day
going
and night.
Home with the Lord.
And he shall be like a tree.
When you
planted
hear
by
my
the rivers
home
of water
going,
that brings
don't
forth
worry
his fruit
about me.
In his season.
When you
his
hear
leaf
my
also
home
shall not
going,
wither,
don't
and
worry
whatsoever
about
he
me.
Doeth shall prosper.
When you hear
the ungodly
my home
are not so,
going,
Well, like the shaft which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous. The ungodly shall perish.
One thing that I know, sure been born again. One thing.